evening here. My name is Frederick Brown. I've been a resident on and off in Bonnet since 1960. I haven't come here tonight to complain about my refuse bin not being collected for the second time in 3 weeks of the new system. That's just a nuisance. What is extreme, this is much more grave, extremely grave, is the real crisis for Bonnet Council in which it finds itself with the ongoing contract with Capita. Let's start with the use of agency and interim staff. Spending on these staff was about 7 million in 2012. This year it's about 18 million. The report on this subject, dated May 2018, states, amongst other things, that there is no agreed policies or procedures for the hiring of agency and interim staff. I repeat that, no agreed policies or procedures for the hiring of agency and interim staff. There's also no expenses cap for these staff. No wonder the overspending for this is massive, and the responsibility for agency staff lies with Capita. Now let's move on to the Grant Thornton report in the fraud case due to Capita's own failings. This report is a severe indictment of this council and its relationship with Capita. The report found there was no effective budgetary control, no checking of basic banking details of staff, inexperienced managers responsible for large amounts of money, no written financial procedures and checklists. If it was an individual member of staff who allowed such an environment to exist in which a major fraud case occurred, they would have got the sack. But because it's a major private company, this council is running away from doing the right thing. That is the sack Capita. On the 19th of July, the P&R committee agreed unanimously to bring a business case of three options, leaving things as they are, bringing some services back in-house, ending both contracts with Capita. There is no report on these three options today. Why have senior officers failed to carry out a committee decision on such a major issue? Why have councillors allowed them to do so? Under what authority can such a crucial committee decision be ignored or put off? We may be told that business case will eventually be done, but by continuing to delay and prevaricate about its relationship with Capita, this council is allowing Capita to continue wasting the taxpayers' money and provide ever worsening and chaotic services. How bad does it have to get before you end Capita contracts? I see that finances and strategic HR will be transferred back by March 2019. Should you not plan now for all services to be transferred back? Allowing Capita to continue is time wasting. There are 8 other local authorities that have done what should be done now, which is end the contracts with Capita. You may dismiss these as political decisions taken by Labour authorities, but as you know, the overwhelming majority of Labour councillors are ultra cautious. You may be reluctant to take a decision to sack Capita because you see it as a political decision. But I understand that most Conservative councillors on this committee have got a legal and accountancy background. Would you, in all honesty, advise a client today to enter into or continue a contract with Capita? Of course not. So why don't you at least act with professional and personal integrity? Kick Capita out now.
Any questions?